zombie apocalypse.
Hey everyone, I've got something very exciting that I'm going to review. I've been waiting for one of these for a very long time. It's a Boglins. These came out in 1987. I always wanted one as a kid. One of the neighbors down the street, they had one. I'd always play with it at their house. Just never managed to convince my parents to buy me one for some reason, but they re-released these previously. They were made up to the, I think, to 94. They were originally made by Mattel, and now I think they're made by, Tri-Action Toys. There was a Kickstarter, and I think they had a, in 2017, there was also a release for maybe a Comic-Con or something. I don't quite remember. You can still find them on eBay. But the problem is the old school foam rubber degrades, you know, pretty drastically, and the used ones are pretty well used. But they, I guess, were successful with their Kickstarter recently, and then they released them to a larger audience. I got mine through Big Bad Toy Store. I'll link the description below. This is the first of the three that are initially coming out. It's King Drool, then it'll be King Dwork, and King Ylob. So those three, the other two haven't come in yet. I did pre-order them. Just because I really wanted one as a kid, never got my chance. I'm happy to get a hold of this. There's also going to be, if you can't tell on the back of the box, the one that looks like a pumpkin, a clown, and then a skeleton. And they might do the mini Boglins, I think. You can pre-order the all six of those first set on Big Bad Toy Store. The second... Really, the other three that are coming out, the pumpkin, the clown, and the skeleton, I think are going to come out around August. I'm not quite sure when the other two are going to hit. I think it's soon. They probably only got a so many to begin with, and this is out of the first wave, probably, and they hopefully were just giving everybody who ordered at least one. So this says... I'll get back around to the front. Come on. Here we go. First edition. I didn't see that on some of the other packaging I've seen in, when you Google pictures of these re-releases. So I'm not sure if this is layover stock from the Kickstarter or not. I think the Kickstarter people got little enamel pins with it, but you know, that would have been cool, but I'm just happy to get a hold of this. Though there is one problem with this one already, which is a little disheartening. I'm going to see if I can fix it, but it looks like one of the arms is detached. It has a little, like, shoulder cap, and that's detached. I'll see if I can just get that back on. It looks like it snaps together. This box is pretty close to the original. I think the size is a little different, but you can punch out the cardboard in the bottom. I'll show that here in a minute, to work the puppet from the inside of the box. And just to get it out, you don't have to destroy the packaging or anything like that, unfold anything. You just undo this little zip tie here, and then you pull the grate up, and then you can get your Boglin out. I think there might be some other zip ties holding it in, but I'll show you the bottom, and then I'll unbox it, and we'll take a closer look. And if anybody is... unfamiliar with Boglins, it's a hand puppet. You can make the eyes look left and right. You can open and close the mouth, and you can blink the eyes. So let me take it off the turntable. I'll just show you that bottom part real quick, and then I'll go ahead and unbox it. Okay, so here's the bottom of the box. It looks like it's semi-perforated, but it does say cut along the line, so I guess X-Acto knife or something. I would do that after it's out of the box, just so you don't accidentally puncture the Boglin itself. So let me open this up, and we'll take a look at it. Oh, also, just the bottom, it kind of gives you a little detailing on how you control it and what to do with it. Okay, so I've got the arm reattached, but you do have to open the box some. There's a panel on the side. Open that up, and then underneath here you will find the tail and then the pieces to attach. The arms attach the exact same way. Comes with a little instruction sheet, probably with a QR code to a video that shows you how to attach the tail to the body. Also, it comes with a little like sheet on your Boglin name and all that, and I guess a little bit of a backstory. Plus, there's a map. I'm hoping and guessing that once I get the other Boglins, it'll help complete a map, a total map. So that's kind of cool. Sorry if that was loud. I was leaning into the camera. Let me scoot in here, and I'll show you how we get this back together. Let's go ahead. There are three holes, and this peg goes through corresponding holes, like so, in focus, come on, match those up with the, his back hole, okay, so like that, and then no particular direction other than just peg goes into hole. Snap it on, and your Boglin has his tail. So, back up a little, getting a good look at him. So your hand goes in the bottom. There's a little flipper, goes up and down to turn his eyes left and right. I forget if his eyes blink or not. I have to look at it real quick. Okay. So there's a little tab that makes him look left and right. And then there's two little tabs that are connected to each brow and lid. So it doesn't have like an eyelid per se, but you can kind of raise his eyebrow and lower it. And then just talking mouth. Sorry if that's close. I've got to try and... There we go. Mm-hmm. So pretty cool. Is that one popping off?
Nope. Okay.
So yeah. No real articulation other than the eyes and mouth. The arms are kind of static, but they seem to wave around quite a bit. Paint apps look pretty good. Some people were complaining. Not complaining, but... The layering on the rubber was coming off on some parts. I do notice that the mold injection, some other people were talking about that. But that's not too bad. As long as you don't have a too massive a hand, you won't be stretching his hole out. Pretty cool. I'm excited to get the other two colors that I pre-ordered. I may or may not get the pumpkin, because I like pumpkins and jack-o'-lanterns and things. Not a lot to say, other than if you were a fan of Boglins, you know, here's your chance to get a hold of one again. I didn't think I'd actually get a brand new Boglin. Thought I was going to have to settle for paying almost too much on eBay for one. But, man, that's cool. Got to figure out a good way to display it. I guess you'd have to take the tail back off to really put it in the box. But other than that, man, that's too cool. I like, you know, trying to remember back. I guess I could, you know, compare pictures. But to me, the sculpt looks maybe a little better on these. So I don't know if it's a completely new sculpt or not that they just took inspiration from the originals. But this is pretty cool. If I get the other two in, you know, in a timely manner, I'll probably do a review on those or at least take pictures for Instagram. So, you know, like, subscribe. Thanks for watching. If you got any comments, please put them below. Got any other fun Boglin facts? Comment that too. Not a lot to say. It's always hard closing these out, you know. The usual like, subscribe, and thanks for watching my channel and, you know, get out and do something.